today I'm going to show you how to create your own Polygon token and launch it on Uniswap. Let's go directly to the process. For doing the whole process, we are going to use Smithii Tools. Smithii Tools is an audited tool suite that allows you to make everything you need to launch your own token in Polygon without coding. We also have other chains like Ethereum, Solana, Base, etc., etc. Make sure you have Polygon selected here, okay, and to connect your wallet in order to start interacting with the tools. First of all, we are going to use Polygon Token Creator. You will have the link in the description, okay? Take an account that all smart contracts you will be seeing here are audited by CoinFabric. You can check the audits here, but anyways, it's safe. So in here, as you can see, we have a tool that allows us to create our own token with custom information, okay? So in here, as you can see, this is a tool that allows us to create our own custom tokens on Polygon with the information we want, and also advanced features that are really interesting. So let's start directly by creating the token. In here, we need to put the name. I will use Jorge, which is my name, okay? Jorge here as well. Then we select the supply. Let's put 1 million, for example. And we go to the interesting part. Here we can set our own tax and the wallet that will receive this tax, okay? In this case, by default, is the one we have connected. And for the fee, I will say that you shouldn't use a really large one because people don't like that at all. In this case, I won't use any fee. Okay. We have also the option to distribute the token directly within different wallets. So if we click here, we can split our token supply within 10 wallets if we want. Okay. We can add and remove them and put the percentage we want. In this case, I won't be doing this also because I just want to show you like the creation itself. Then we have more token features and advanced options, which are anti-bot, anti-whale, and airdrop mode, okay? As you can see, anti-bot essentially is a feature that prevents any bot from trading your token by blocking them to buy and sell within the same block, okay? So we can activate it if we want to avoid bots when launching it. So we continue with anti-whale. Here we have different settings we can add, essentially to avoid whales to trade our token. And what we can do is the token limit per trade, which is essentially setting a maximum of tokens that anyone can buy or sell within the same transaction. Then we have the time limit per trade on hours, essentially how much time should happen between each transaction per wallet. So if we set here 1 hour, I will be able to sell to buy, for example, and I won't be able to buy or sell within 1 hour. Then we have the total limit per wallet. This will be the total amount that a single wallet can hold of our token, okay? And then the active period, that will be how much time we want this anti-whale to be active. Then we have the other mode that essentially disable people to send or trade the token until we deactivate it. This is usually used for projects that I'm going to use an airdrop, but it's essentially blocking everyone to move the token from their wallet, okay? So this is what we got. In this case, I'm only going to use Antibot for the example, okay? So the total fees are 49 pol, okay? If we are not adding any of the features, if we add Antibot, for example, it will be 64 pol. So we just need to click on create token. We will see the transaction here. Perfect. Here we have the total fee, $50 so far. We click on confirm. And there we go. It's loading. This is the token address of the token we are creating, okay? First, the tool will create the token, and then we will enable the antipod feature we have selected, okay? So there are two transactions. This is the first one, and this is the second one. We confirm. Perfect. And now, as we can see, we have our token ready. Let's copy the token address, okay? Let's go to Polygon Scan. Perfect. And here we can look for our token. This one, this is the new token we have created, okay? Here we can see Jorge. Okay, as you can see, the total supply is 1 million. As we said, we have one holder, which is our wallet, okay? And this is the token information. Two important things. In here, we have the contract already verified, okay? As it is an audited contract, it's already verified by Polygon Scan, so we don't need to verify it in order to add more information to our token. Because yes, if you wanna add more information like socials, logo, etc., you can do it directly here in Polygon Scan, okay? You need to click here and update token info, okay? You will need to log in, create an account, demonstrate that you are the owner by connecting your wallet, and then you will be able to modify all this information, okay? This is important because you already have the contract verified, so you won't have any problem when doing this update of the information. Then, second important thing is, what should I do if I have activated any feature and I want to change anything, or I wanna activate them later? We have the token manager. Okay, in here you can manage the token settings, manage the anti-bot, and manage the anti-whale. Okay, if we come here and we select the token we have just created, here we have different options. Okay, if we have the tax applied, we will be able to change it. If we have airdrop mode activated, we will be able to deactivate it here. And also we can blacklist addresses in here. This is really useful, okay? In token manager, we also have the manage antibot. We will see how it works. In here, we can change the status of the antibot, enable or disable it, as well as exempting addresses from the antibot. So we can exempt our address from being affected from this filter, okay? This is really cool. And we also have the manage anti-whale, where we can now activate the anti-whale because we didn't have it, or modify it if we already had it, okay? It is really, really useful in order to manage these features and settings we have available. So now that we have our token ready, we just need to go to create the liquidity pool in order to allow people to trade it. To do that, we have here the create liquidity pool option, okay? Your liquidity pool will be directly created on Uniswap, so people will be able to trade it on Uniswap, DexTool, DexScreener, etc. So for creating our liquidity pool, we just need to select the base token, which will be our token, the token without value in the market yet. Then the quote token, I recommend you to use Matic. Okay, in this case, it will be Grabmatic. In this case, it will be Grabmatic because for creating the liquidity pool, we need to put Grab token. Okay, so you need to swap Pol to Grabmatic or Grab Pol. It's the same. Then select how much liquidity you want to add. In this case, I will be selecting all. Let me grab some Matic for a second. So we select maximum. Why not? You need to make your tokenomics, etc., before launching the LP for sure. So think about this before launching, and then we select how much Grabmatic we wanna add. In this case, I won't do it because I don't have, but it's essentially clicking on the create liquidity pool button. You will need to confirm a transaction, and the liquidity pool will be directly added here. So we will be able to trade it on Uniswap, okay? It's that easy, it's that simple. So as you can see, this is how easily you can launch your own token in Polygon and make it go to the moon. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye bye.